Hello, everyone. Rodney here at Klebs Tech, and today I'm going to go over the latest update to Fooocus. Sorry for the delay on this video. I woke up to a flooded downstairs in my house the other day from a leak and have been dealing with that. I'm not going to dive deep into every single thing that was updated. I'm going to cover the ones that are most likely to impact most users. For all the changes, you can check out the update on GitHub, which I will include a link to in the description. Now, the first thing you're probably going to notice is the new selection of presets is available under the Advanced tab. Now, this feature accommodates all custom presets created by the user alongside the standard presets bundled with Fooocus, facilitating easier and quicker switching between settings, since you can now switch between presets during a session. Keep in mind, if you select one that you've not used, it will download any models that are needed as soon as you select it, and you'll have to wait till that's finished. When you select each preset, all the options for that preset will change, as can be seen here. When I change the anime, it also changes the model and any other settings for that preset. Now, you can also disable the preset options by adding the disable preset selection to your bat files. So one of the bigger changes is the new lightning preset and performance option. When you select this, it'll enable the four-step lightning LoRa, which you can use with any regular SDXL model to get the faster image generation. Like on this one, I'm currently running it with the Juggernaut. There's no LoRa enabled in here, but it is in the background when you do choose that. You'll actually notice it in the log file. So mine is showing as LoRa 6, but I only have 5 LoRAs listed on here and it won't show in there. Now, when you do set this, it will also disable the negative prompt and it won't show you the generations as they're done. They'll only show the final images. I have not fully tested it to see how it compared to using a dedicated lightning model specifically. It does seem to work pretty well when I've used it and experimented with some of the other models. More on that, I'm sure, in some later videos. Now, the other thing that has changed is in the styles. You'll notice instead of having this jumbled mess of different boxes in here, they're now all in just in 2 straight up columns, nice and evenly organized. So that should make it a lot easier to use styles. Another change would be to the wildcards. So the first step with wildcards is you can now do subdirectories. So if you have a lot of wildcards, you can now organize them with subdirectories and it'll read those. The other change to wildcards is in the advanced developer debug mode. You can go down in the debug tools down towards the bottom and you'll find a new checkbox to read wildcards in order. And that's exactly what it does. It goes through one at a time. I find actually allows for some new interesting ways of doing things, one that I'll be demonstrating in my next video. When you click on anime for a preset, it has changed. Instead of using the Fooocus Enhanced, they've now created a new style called Fooocus Semi-Realistic, which is supposed to give better results when creating anime. Some of the stuff that was in the Fooocus Enhanced didn't do well when generating for anime, so they've made those changes. Another change for anybody that uses Fooocus on Google Colab, there's been changes made to prioritize VRAM over RAM, which should help with preventing out-of-memory issues. Now, the last change I'm gonna cover is more behind the scenes when it comes to the Inpainting. When using Inpainting, there's a synthetic refiner that switches over, and previously it was set at 0.5 or 50%. So you get about halfway through when you're Inpainting and using like face swap, and the face would look like the one you were swapping to, and then you'd hit a spot at about 50% where it would start changing. Well, the reason for that was hitting that refiner and that would change it. So they've now adjusted that. So instead of it kicking over at 50%, you'll see here, it gets up to about 80% because that's the default, and then it will kick over to the refiner. So you end up getting much better results with the Inpainting and the face swap by using that. So you used to go in and manually adjust that. And that's around what I found as well, was that 80% mark seemed to be roughly about the best spot for that. So if you were in a habit of going in and overriding the refiner switch when you did the face swap and Inpainting, you probably won't have to do that anymore. Now, there are some other changes as well, and you can check those out by following the link to the GitHub page to learn more about them. Also, if you encounter any bugs, do head over and check out the GitHub page, since I've seen some people have had some issues with custom presets and things like that. I haven't actually really encountered anything for the most part that I can see. Well, that concludes this Fooocus update video. If you found it helpful, please do consider hitting the like button because it does help. Thanks for watching and have fun creating.